Greetings, LGR here. Let's talk about PC games and why I think they're awesome, because I like doing that. And we're also going to do so because of YouTube's Awesome Stuff Week Unwrapped, which is what this video is a part of. They approached me and said, would you like to do a video if we pay you? And I'm like, sure. So this is what we're going to talk about, because they gave me free rein of what I wanted to talk about and what I wanted to say about it. So that's pretty awesome. This is the wireless adapter for Windows for Xbox One controllers, which fits in with YouTube's Tech Unwrapped theme that they have going on for this day of Awesome Stuff Week. So let's take a look at this thing. I may be a die-hard mouse and keyboard guy when it comes to most PC games, but I've always enjoyed using a console controller for things like arcade racing games and platformers. I remember when I was a kid, the grandfather of a friend of mine cobbled together an adapter that let us play Jazz Jackrabbit for MS-DOS on a Sega Genesis gamepad, and it blew my prepubescent mind. Ever since then, I've been intrigued by the ability to use console controllers on a PC, whether unofficial or official. The latest one to come across my path is an official accessory from Microsoft, retailing at $25 for the adapter alone and $80 for a controller and adapter together. This is a USB 2.0 dongle that proudly wears the shell of a Wi-Fi adapter from like 6 years ago, and I'm not sure why. I mean, does this really need to be almost 3.5 inches long and an inch wide? What's it housing in there, a Hot Wheels car? And while it says it's for Windows, look a bit closer because it actually means it's for Windows 10 only. So if you're still on 7 or 8 or use something like SteamOS or Linux, then you're out of luck. I don't get it. Microsoft released drivers for using the X1 controller with a USB cable already, so why not do so with the wireless adapter? Oh well, at least it's crazy simple to install. All you do is plug it into a USB port, press the sync buttons on both the adapter and the controller, and there you go. Windows 10 comes with the drivers already installed, but it's a good idea to have Windows Update check for newer ones anyway, since some users reported a lack of rumble with the default drivers. But yeah, this is exactly what I was hoping for. Ease of use and plug-and-play compatibility. In case you haven't noticed, most PC games nowadays use the X Input API for detecting and mapping controllers, so having one that makes use of this makes things super straightforward. And yes, you can use the Xbox One controller on your PC already, just using a micro USB cable, and that's great for when I'm playing at my desk. But I also have my PC connected to my TV when I'm in the mood for more relaxed gaming, so a wireless controller is a nice thing to have in that case. Whether I'm playing something new like Next Card Game Wreckfest or something classic like Commander Keen Goodbye Galaxy, the Xbox One controller adapter gave me no trouble at all. It also has the ability to recognize multiple controllers at once, so you can play split-screen games without having to take up multiple USB ports. However, I do have a minor complaint. There doesn't seem to be a way to turn off the controllers once you're done playing. When you unplug the adapter, the controllers will flash because they've lost sync, but in order to turn them off, you either have to wait for them to just time out or remove the battery pack. That's a bit clunky. Anyway, you may be wondering why bother with a $25 adapter for wireless at all. After all, there are great gamepads that don't use locked down proprietary wireless signals, like the PlayStation 4 controller for instance. And actually, that's what I've been using for a wireless controller up to this point. Not only do I prefer the PS4 gamepad in several areas, but it doesn't require any special adapter to work on a PC. Since it uses Bluetooth, you can just use your computer's built-in Bluetooth capabilities or use one of these adapters that cost less than 10 bucks. But the problem with these is that there's no official support for it from Sony, which means you're stuck messing around with third-party drivers and software. There's just a lot of setup involved compared to the plug-and-play nature of an Xbox controller, and since I'm freaking lazy, the Xbox wireless adapter appeals to me on a carnal, lethargic level. So while it may not be my preferred controller overall, the brain-dead use makes the Windows wireless adapter for the Xbox One controller a fantastic accessory in my book. Anyway, that was the wireless adapter for the Xbox One controller for Windows. Pretty sweet little thing if you are feeling lazy and have Windows 10 at the same time. So if you'd like to, you can always shop through this video. This is a thing that they're doing. I think that's the entire reason they wanted me to do this. Or you could just check out some of the other Awesome Stuff Week videos By clicking on the outro at the end of this. But yeah, oh, this thing is really hot. I'm getting rid of it.